Hello, Baraboo Traders Community. This is Nick Dubrinov. I want to do a recap for the one trade that I took today. I traded ALXN. ALXN was gapping down because Amgen is challenging some of their patents. So it really gapped down very hard. It was minus 8% around that level here, 133. Then it moved even further down and came back up a little bit. When the market opened, it really started trading very erratically. So you can see the big wicks to the top and the bottom. Then it started moving down. It bounced off of VWAP very fast, and I entered the first position here. It wasn't a very small size, so I didn't really enter a very small size here, which was a big mistake. Then it started bouncing up. To the upside, it bounced again off of VWAP. A little bit of uncertainty here, then I added to my position again. So overall, I took a too large position in this trade, and all of a sudden I got stuck short here because it moved very quickly up and started just chopping around VWAP. So what made me really stay in this trade was this 1 minute wick here, which then manifested on the 5 minute charts. You can see it's like a shooting star, very high, and it sold off quickly. But then I did not exit here because of this large wick, and then it started moving against me. So over here, when it moved towards the peak here, I was about $1,000 negative. And I basically froze here. I wasn't sure what to do anymore because I thought this is gonna move higher. And by the time that happened, basically it started moving down again. So it's making new wicks. Again, a wick to the upside, a wick long wick to the upside. These are kind of good indicators to me that it's going to start moving down. And then all of a sudden, with very large volume, it moves down here. And once it got to the VWAP, it started chopping again. It wasn't really sure what it wants to do, but slowly started grinding down. And at that point, once it moved below VWAP, it became very weak. So I'm very intensively looking at watching the time and sales and the level 2. And it was showing a weak spot after weak spot. The whole thing is red, almost the whole thing is red at the current price. Then it moves down a leg, then it starts chopping, then again the whole time in sales is right at the current price, it moves down. And so that basically intensively watching the time in sales and the level 2 is what kept me in this trade for a very long time. So I was really looking to first partial when I get to this technical level here, which is a daily level. It's 99.80, about 99.80. I partialed half of my position here, and half of my position I sold later on. Now, how did I decide to exit here? I thought at that point one is that this was very extended, so I didn't think it's going to go to our next level, which is 96.21. This was going to be too big of a move, so I didn't trust it's going to do that. And the other thing that I was seeing here is that it consistently was bouncing off 99.1. So you see how many times it bounced here, and it immediately gets bought back up. And with not very small volumes, you can see this large volume wicks, large volume bars. And so my goal at this point became to exit completely as close to 99.1 as possible. And that's what I did. And you can see after this, it didn't really go much lower. So the lowest, it just dipped below 99. And then now it's moving up, and who knows what it's going to do. So overall, very bad management in the first part of the trade. I really got stuck here. I froze. So then once it started moving in my direction, I managed the trade very well, I think. But overall, this is a very bad example of how you should enter. First, enter with very large size, and how you should manage the position once it moves against you. So overall, I'm giving myself maybe a 2 out of a 10 in how I managed that position. But I ended up lucky today, and I didn't take another trade because I saw that everything's chopping up with SPY. It's not sure where it wants to go. So I saw people trying to trade Dell and BIC, and you can see it's just chopping around. It's not really sure what it wants to do, so I didn't take any more trades. Have a great weekend. That's all from me for today. Bye bye.